Alrighty, people, let's beat Dead Space. I was on my way to the solar array in order to get power back into the Titan station. Before I could get there, though, I had to launch this lift back to where it belonged. While on the lift, a bunch of tripods started to attack. Now, I think I held up a pretty damn good fight, if I do say so myself, but eventually I was too overwhelmed and died due to a fatal hit that shattered all 206 bones that were in my body. Now, I'm not sure what happened, but after I died, the lift was crooked. I could not get into it no matter what I did. I'm guessing the game just glitched somehow. One can only assume it just couldn't handle how good of a player I was, so it tried to stop me from actually accomplishing this challenge. A quick reload to the last checkpoint easily fixed this problem. This time, I was ready. Inhuman speed was all I needed in order to get past this part. Now remember, if any of you hate your life as much as I do and want to attempt this challenge, make sure you use your environment. Anything from the explosive canisters, to corpses, to even green canisters can be used to prevent ammo usage. After a lot of hacking and puzzle solving, I got rid of a bootleg Cortana who gave me access to the solar array. Now here, I was tasked to realign these solar panels. Sounds simple, right? That's because it is. Until you take into consideration that there is this nest that shoots weird alien fleshlights at me. Like I'm talking, I'll be trying to align these satellites from when out of nowhere I'll get hit with one of his sex toys. I aligned all of the satellites and got the power finally back on. I received a message from Ellie who told me that her and Nolan are being overrun by necromorphs, so me being the man simping over her, I launched myself straight to her rescue. After a very smooth landing, I went ahead and saved my senpai. Of course, I did die a few times trying to save her. I died like this, like that, like this, ooh, and like this. I died like this a lot, actually. Instead of getting a kiss for heroically saving her, Ellie sends me coordinates to the central hub in order to meet up with her and Nolan. I need you guys to understand just how much of a fast thinker I am. I mean, just look at this. Do you see this? You see, I'm not that bad at playing games. I just have my moments. Anyways, as I was thrusting my way through this area, Tywin decided to turn on all the mechanics again, thinking that it will stop me. Well, I mean, obviously it didn't. Does he not know who he's dealing with? Like, I'm the main protagonist in the video game. I won the moment the developers even thought of Isaac. I killed this nest, and with that, I made it to Ellie and Nolan. She tells me that the only way out of this facility is using the industrial transport, so it was my job to go ahead and call it in. Now, as you can see, I had a bit of trouble getting past this area because of the leapers that were literally everywhere. Eventually, I got to where I had to be, and of course, the release mechanism was broken. I went ahead and fixed it, and got into the transport. On our way out, I got a glimpse of the Ishimura. I never want to go back to that goddamn forsaken ship ever again. It gave me nightmares. The transport suddenly stopped, and apparently something was blocking the tracks. It turned out to be these huge tentacles that were doing just that. Thankfully, they were also wrapped around these explosive canisters. Tripods spawned in and gave me some trouble. Now, I knew that saving ammo would come in handy later, and it did. I took some of it, and it helped me get past all of these tripods. And after finally getting back onto the transport, Tidman, from out of nowhere, uses the solar beam in order to cut the tracks in two. All hope was lost until I remembered that the Ishimura had gravity tethers. Now I could use these tethers in order to hold the tracks together just long enough for Ellie and Nolan to get across it. I didn't want to do it, but who actually cares about what I think? Going across this long tunnel gave me nightmares. I was not prepared for what was to come. Every step I took inside of this ship gave me deja vu. All the memories from the previous game flooded back to me and smacked me right in the face. It felt like just yesterday I was on the Ishimura seeing my comrades get killed. While marching through the various areas of the Ishimura, I made it to one hell of a roadblock. A roadblock so hard that it actually made me think that my run was over. I had to fight two enhanced brutes and an enhanced slasher and an enhanced lurker plus a little exploding baby. Which isn't too bad since there's a lot of space to run around, but the problem was that I had no ammo. The little ammo I came in with was the exact amount I needed to just kill the first brute. After that, I was out. On top of this, there was no store to get the ammo I saved, so I was completely lost in terms of what I was going to do. I ran all the way back to the start of the ship, but found nothing. Only one pack of ammo, which isn't a lot in Zealot mode. Now I'm going to explain my strategy for this part, so pay close attention. I had enough ammo to kill the first brute, so after killing him, you get a checkpoint, so you won't have to fight him again. I turned around and ran back to collect an ammo pack that's on some box and froze the second brute once it appeared. I made sure to refill my stasis and froze both the slasher and the lurker as soon as I saw them. I then shot the little baby's head off and carefully used it to blow up both the lurker and the slasher. I grabbed any ammo they dropped and quickly turned around to freeze the brute once more. At this point, I just kept refilling my stasis and ran around carefully trying to shoot its weak points. Not missing a single shot was key to this strategy. Now I forgot to stomp the slasher I killed, so I went back and did it and it gave me some more ammo. Even with the extra ammo, I still did not have enough. So what I did was use the broom on the floor to dismember the arm of this brute. Once I took its arm off, I basically won. I carefully grabbed the bombs it threw at me and shot them back at the brute until it eventually exploded. Luckily, if you're smart enough to come into the Ishimura with more ammo, you won't need to do this. With this out of the way, I made it to the gravity centrifuge and repaired it. I activated the gravity tethers and got Ellie and Nolan across the track safely. After seeing my dead girlfriend once again, I took the escape pod to leave the Ishimura and crash landed back into the Titan. I received a transmission which showed Nolan trying to stab Ellie's eyes with the screwdriver, but right before seeing the impact, the signal cut out. I made it to a very dark cave filled with necromorphs that needed killing and power cells that needed replacing. I restored power to the doors in the cave and made it out. I then got greeted by Nolan, who had Ellie's eye on his screwdriver. He tells me that I'm next, and Ellie smacks the daylights out of him for talking that smack. After this, a drag tentacle drags me out into space, and my only way back into the facility was blocked by these giant lasers. Using the thrusters, I moved the lasers out of the way, giving me access back into the station. While hacking the door, Nolan attacks me with his screwdriver. I didn't want to, but he left me no other choice. I inserted the screwdriver into the side of his head, killing him instantly. I gave him a proper send-off and found myself inside the mines. I took an elevator ride up, which included many waves of slashers and many deaths. This tight space posed quite a challenge, but all you needed to pass this part was luck and perfection. As soon as I left the elevator and opened the door, Nicole started to choke me out, but only after admitting the fact that I can't let her go and that she was my everything, she stopped and told me that the final step was acceptance. In the mines, Ellie found this huge drill and it was my job to go ahead and fix it. I grabbed the power cell I needed and the circuit junction I needed and repaired it. I took the lift up to the drill and I was in for the ride of my life. You see, Ellie was driving this drill all the way to the government sector as I tried to fend off waves of enemies boarding this drill. This was easy up until the lurkers because I had no health, so I was basically a one-shot. Trying to avoid their attacks was like trying to avoid water after jumping into a pool. I basically just did trial and error until I beat this section and made it to the government sector. Ellie ends up finding a gunship that is fully operational. This means that her and Isaac can finally escape this madness once and for all. But Isaac felt that he needed to put an end to this, so he launches her off, leaving him alone with nothing but his thoughts of Nicole. On my way to destroy the marker, a bunch of security officers attempted to block my way through. I did something that I was not proud of and released an onslaught of enemies onto these poor men. I hope God will forgive me for the sin I just committed. I ran past blood and death and made it to some lasers revolving around the room. Now, due to my lack of stasis, I literally had the exact amount of stasis to make it past this part. I literally could not mess up a single shot of stasis, or else this room just became impossible. You just can't do it. You'll see in the kill count how many times I messed up this part. It isn't pretty. To no one's surprise, I made it to another brute with yet again not that much ammo. Luckily though, I remembered that I left an exploder alive, so I used his bomb and this stasis canister in order to basically one-shot this bastard. I eventually made it to the marker. It was quite a sight to behold seeing the sheer amount of necromorphs surrounding it. The fact that humans were able to build a device of this magnitude was mind-blowing. I stepped into this machine and inserted this needle into my eye in order to acquire the knowledge I needed to destroy this marker. With my mind now working at a full 100%, the game threw an ubermorph at me to try and stop me. It's basically just a hunter from the first game, only cooler looking. I used this dead corpse in order to unlock the door and kept running. This whole game basically becomes a marathon until I reached the final boss. It was a pain in the ass since all the enemies were basically enhanced and I was too stubborn to use any ammo. I died a lot trying to run to the final boss. But you know what? I also learned a lot. I learned how to evade and use anything I could to my advantage. I basically became a master at critical thinking. Dodging obstacles left and right without a hassle was my middle name. Now I won't lie, here and there I did die just a couple of times, but eventually I made it. Tideman attempted to kill me, but I got the upper hand. I turned his head into a liquid and proceeded to the final boss. Now, let me tell you something. This final boss kicked my ass really badly. Like it kicked my ass unnecessarily hard. Nicole would grab me and instantly kill me from out of nowhere. And if that didn't happen, then the pack would just tear me apart. Now ammo was quite a problem here. So after each wave, there would be about 3 children that spawn in, who I would have to farm until I got enough ammo to continue on. And it takes a while, by the way, to do that. So after farming, I would proceed to damage the boss only to die by the pack once again. Once they hit you, you basically get stunned for a little bit, so you better pray that another child does not jump on you, or else you're dead. Also, they don't drop health, and I came into this boss fight with no medkit whatsoever. I believe they dropped a health pack maybe 6 times throughout the countless amount of times I tried this. So basically, getting hit is out of the question. In order to beat this, it was literally just me running around shooting 2 or 3 children that were in my way and waiting for the horde to be all behind me so I can take them all out. Then I just farmed ammo and repeated the steps. It was just so annoying that every death had a long animation because the developers didn't think someone would see that death more than 50 times. Well, I did. I can't even begin to tell you how long this took me. I have one clip of just the boss fight and it's 1 hour and 15 minutes long. That isn't taking into account the other video I attempted on the second day, which is like another 40 minutes. Now I know 2 hours may not seem like a lot, but when it's 2 hours of just hearing the same audio over and over again while dying over and over again, trust me, it will get to you. Even after defeating the boss, I was not happy because the boss fight single-handedly made the kill count video so much longer than it already was. Look, making those kill counts is a nightmare depending on the amount of deaths I get in the game, so I really try my hardest to just minimize the amount of death I have. And after knowing how many times I died in this fight, I just wasn't looking forward to making the kill count for this video. But whatever. The marker blew up and I escaped with Ellie. So with this, the game was finally done. It was over. My torture was over. Now here's the question. Can you beat Dead Space 2 without upgrading, without using the store, on Zlop mode, with only the plasma cutter? Yes, you can, but I'd advise to only do it if you want to really punish yourself for something bad that you did. With that all being said, I just want to say thank you guys for watching, and to please stick around for the next video in which I will try to tackle Dead Space 3. Leave a challenge down below in the comments of any game or anything you want me to do, and please subscribe if you can. Subscribing really puts me at ease when making these challenges. I will see you guys in the next video. Peace out.